It's P5. We're back with more Kirby Dreams. In the last episode, we went through Yogurt Yard, and this episode, we're going to go through Orange Ocean. And it's going to be real fun, because I got Hammer still, and I can wreck shop, especially in this water. Because everything in the water moves nice and slow, so you don't got to worry about getting your ass kicked. I don't want throw. I can't even use that underwater. Of course, knowing my luck, you probably need throw. Although, what would you need throw for? What, breaking metal blocks? I can do that with hammer, thank you. Well, don't even lose it! Okay. Okay, there you go. Nice round 29. Dude! Okay. Moving on. I love the backbeat on this song. It's so relaxing. What do we have inside here? Some stuff that I really wish I had hammer for. See, it's moments like this, you need an ability that can break metal blocks that can hit things on the ground. If I still had hammer, that would be no problem. But I don't. So I wonder if I can inhale both of these sparkies and get, like, rock or something. Well, they have to be both on the right side. Come on. Dude, you gotta stop that horse crap now. Okay, now, see, here's the thing. Yeah, like, stand over... There you go. Now give me stone. Wheel? Is that gonna do it? I don't think... maybe. Yeah, it will. Awesome. And there's the switch. That's one thing that Wheel does have going for it, is that it's really easy to break metal blocks with it. Can't break metal blocks above you, but very few abilities can. Like, pretty much hammer is all you can... Hammer or throw is about all you can hope for in that case. Man, the sun is coming right through my window, right onto my face, and it's really distracting. I hope this episode goes well, because I don't know how long this world is. This is probably the world in the game that I'm least familiar with, honestly. Because Orange Ocean is just kind of like that whatever world between Yogurt Yard and the final world, which is really cool. The final world has a really, really nice song. Can't wait to get there. Can't wait! Goodness, these episodes have been big. I'm just looking over at my Bandicam window. And these last three episodes have been like 600 megabytes. Because I'm actually recording them in a higher size, because John commented, like, this quality is killing me, and I agree. The quality on the first few episodes of this has been just fuck awful. Because I'm recording in a resolution that's actually smaller than the YouTube default video size. So there's like mathematically no way the quality could be any good. So I'm recording in a bigger size now, and I haven't actually looked at any of the episodes I've recorded today, which is not a good idea to record this far into the game without checking that. But what's in here? Holy crap! Okay. Hello! anyway, man, he just popped out right next to me. Would you stop that? That is so annoying! Jeez. How many times can I voice crack in one sentence? Like you want to talk about stuff that's annoying, try your fucking voice cracks, man. Holy shit. Get out of here. Thank you for not shooting me, like, right at point-blank range. Because you almost did, and I'm a little low on health. For some reason, I always remember this episode, or this particular area. Ah, damn it. I don't suppose it's possible for me to get rock anywhere, because I really should have probably tried to keep that into that area. Thankfully, you can, if you miss a switch and you go back for it... Ah, nice. If you miss a switch and you go back for it, you can just leave the level after you hit the switch. You don't have to complete the level again. Ow, that was bad. Oh, shit. Dude, I don't... Aw, man! That would have been a really opportune time to show that off, that you can actually get those maximum tomatoes. Of course, I already showed that, but that would have been a good time to take advantage of it for the first time in the LP. That was really close. I almost just died there. If I had been, like, one block down, that would have killed me. But anyway. Well, let's head through that level again, because I'm pretty sure I missed a switch by not going through that door. Yeah, fuck. Anyway, let's try that again. I love this music. Fuck. Man, these fucking Scarfies just flying out of the sky cheerfully. This is, it's like the epitome of cheerfully, because they got that stupid smile on their face. They're just so happy. Like, jeez, man. Hey, get out of here. Don't even come down here. Stone! There we go. Now let's not lose this, shall we? Yeah, just don't get hit by these Scarfies. Seriously. I'm trying to eat my fish. It keeps falling off the fucking plate, man. And don't lose it in here, either. You know? Just use stone to make yourself invulnerable to that guy's explosion. Tip over this guy once he shoots. Safety first. Yeah, I lost it there. Like, I didn't even try to get it back. Probably, I should have known that I would need that later, but anyway. Oh, you know what I bet you can do? I bet if you inhaled both of these guys, you'd get stone. If you inhaled both of those Sparkies in that room there, I bet you'd get stone. But anyway, that's all. Let's get out of here. What's level? The museum has a wheel, that's right. I remember. So let's just move on here. I like this level. It's like we're on a ship or something. You never really see ships in the Kirby series. Like, you see spaceships and warships, but not a lot of pirate ships, which is kind of disappointing. I'd like to see more pirate ships. Oh man, it's this level. I remember this level. This level's got, if I remember correctly, this level has a really confusing puzzle. At least it does. At least it's really confusing in Kirby's Adventure, because like the graphics aren't good enough to exactly show you what you need to do. It's really some really esoteric puzzle solution. I don't remember. Yeah, I don't know this game as well as I know like Return to Dreamland and Squeak Squad, so you'll have to forgive me. You'll have to forgive my incompetence. Oh, I remember. You can fill this area with water. You might think, oh, I need to do something with this water, but actually, it's just because you opened a hole in the ship's hull, and you can actually leave through that hole to get a 1-up. And if you can nail that, you gotta nail it. Now pull down, and you can actually get that 1-up right before you go off screen and die. No! Ah, come on. Oh, jeez! Oh, no! I wonder if I actually need this laser. This laser. What's in here? Ah, yes, you do need laser, because laser can actually light these fuses. I can't. Really? Okay, fine. I guess I can't. There you go. I can't go down through that platform, but here you go. Man, three switches. Three levels in a row that have switches. Good gravy. That's crazy. We're only 8 minutes into this video, and I'm only three levels in. Like, this is gonna take forever. This world might take a little longer. Oh, this is another level that I think of whenever I think about this game. This is another room, because, like, just look at these sails. Like, how cool is this? Like, this is a big-ass ship, let me tell you what. Also one of the few warp stars in the game. I haven't really pointed these out, but I don't know why, like, only some areas in the game have warp stars, but it's pretty cool. It's like a little treat. You get to watch this little itty-bitty cutscene. It's pretty much been like that throughout the entire series. Sometimes there's just a random level that has a warp star spot in it. Kirby's Return to Dreamland, I think, only has two. There's like one in the first level and one in the final level. That you ride through a bunch of crystals or something that look like the final boss arena from Squeak Squad. But anyway, let's move on to level 4. Got the Ice Cream Island music, the grooving ass music, the grooviest music in any Kirby game. I don't know about that. There's some pretty awesome songs later in the series. I don't want to go so far as to say this is the grooviest, you know. Because that's probably just a flat-out lie, honestly. Quite irresponsible of me to suggest such a fraudulent thing. Oh man, I want that so bad. I gotta respawn. Oh fuck, I don't think I can! Oh no! Oh no, I totally can. There you go. Oh, dude, get down here. What?! I didn't know it was humanly possible for one man to suck that much at this game. Anyway, break that open, you can get a whole bunch of extra lives down here. I think. I don't think there's anything getting in my way, no. 34, that's not a very good number. Ow, would you stop getting hit? You're so stupid. And the sun, would you quit shining into my face? You're really distracting. Ugh. Oh, I love these sword knights. If you throw a cutter at them, they'll actually just swat it out of the air with their sword. It's pretty badass. Although it makes you wonder why they even gave you cutter there, but to show you that that happened. Yeah, that's really useful information. And this is where that 1-up fell down before, so you can get another one. 35, that's a better number. That's a nice multiple of 7. Although it's not a very satisfying number, because no multiple of 5 is really that satisfying. They're just not that interesting. It's like, oh, it's a multiple of 5. Whoop-de-fucking-do. This is totally a door. Yeah, I got your number. Oh boy, Kirby's air grind. I guess I shouldn't be surprised that it's not lagging that much when I record in a higher size, because after all, you know, my computer can successfully record Majora's Mask, you know, which isn't a, not that that's a super intensive game or anything, but it's more intensive than a Game Boy Advance game, that's for damn sure. Oh, I should have picked up one of those umbrellas! Be careful, man. Jeez. Okay. We already got the Switch in this level, so I don't need to pick up anything else. I don't need to look for anything else. There you go, no problem. Nah, almost. Almost that perfect one. You know, I haven't mentioned it so far, but there's actually a really, really hard-to-get secret you can do in this game. If you get 7 on that goal game, and then you get 6, and then you get 5, and then you get 4, and then 3, 2, 1, you get, like, 30 lives. It's crazy. This is weird. The music that's playing right now is actually the World 7 music. They play it, like, in the last 2 levels of World 6 before you're supposed to, like, hear it for the first time, which is really weird. I don't know why they did that. Because you'd think they'd want to save this music for when you actually make it to World 7 so that it has more of an impact. I mean, every other world song in the game, they did that. Why not do it for this, for World 7? Especially the final world, you'd think they would want to save that music. Fine. I'll take Needle. Fucking late. Or what even hit me? Anyway, it was this guy jumping down from the sky. Cheerfully. Man, this level's such a pain in the ass, because you gotta climb up this mountain and shit's flying at you, and there's a guy there, and he's running at me, and I'm scared. Would you get out of here? Thank you. Da-da. Also, back in these days, like, before the advent of spray paints, which not that they put spray paints in the games nowadays, which I really wish they would, but, like, Kirby and the Amazing Mirror and Kirby's Squeak Squad both had spray paints that you could collect that would color Kirby a different color. And I really loved that. It introduced me to role-playing. I used to choose different spray paints and role-play a different Kirby with, like, a different personality and everything. When I played, like, Kirby in the Amazing Mirror, one of my mainstay OCs for one of my big old mythos was actually created that way when I invented the persona of Chocolate Kirby. Would you stop fucking killing me? Jeez. I'm just trying to eat my fish. I really hate this level. Like, ugh, such a pain in the ass. Get out of here. I'm not interested in what you're selling. Let's just stand here, wait for that fuse to run out because I accidentally lit it. I thought I would have been far enough away, but I guess not. Yeah, it actually grows back. I don't know how that works, but... So you can set it off again. Fly up. I don't even care. You know? There you go. Made it. Yeah! And a switch, which will fully heal us. So that's nice. And it unlocks a quick draw, which I don't want to do. So that's cool. I think level 6 in this world is actually really short. Like, I'm pretty sure it's just a fight with the Meta Knights, because, well, you'll see. So happy. That's it for level 5. Level 6 going on stage 6? I don't know. Yeah, this is another... this is so weird. They use the level 7, like, the World 7 signature song in 2 awkward levels of World 6. Like, wouldn't you want to save that for when you actually get to World 7? Well, I think there's a secret you can get in this level. But you have to figure out which of these... Okay, that's not gonna do it. You need to, like, you need to figure out which of these two enemies is it. Maybe it's, is it Spark and Spark? Maybe it's Spark and Spark. I wouldn't be surprised if it was. Yeah, Hammer. Spark and Spark gives you Hammer. Now you just gotta, now you just have to keep this Hammer and bring it down here where you can use it to, oh, it's close. Okay, come in here and then I'm gonna switch. So yay! And that unlocks the warp door for this world. I haven't shown it at all, but those doors with the warp stars on them, with the warp stars above them, those are like warp, they're the doors to the warping areas, so you can warp between the worlds without needing to walk all the way around. But it's pretty like, oh, I balls it up. That is how I died most by accident in these games, is by accidentally inhaling an enemy and then falling down a pit, because you can't puff up until you spit it out, and usually you don't have time to spit it out, get through all the ensuing in-between frames, and then, would you fucking go away? Jeez, how many of you guys are there? There's one of these rooms in every Kirby game, though, a room where you encounter like 17 million UFO enemies. Even though, like, most Kirby games after a certain point didn't have UFO, Planet Robobot introduced it again. You could, if you scanned the Kirby amiibo with Robobot, you'd actually get, the UFO ability. Oh, fuck, which one is it? I don't know. I'm just gonna guess up. Well, didn't I already get a switch in this level? Look, there's no way there's actually another switch in this world. You know, that's not how this game fucking works. Thank you for going on that side. That means I can kick both your asses with one giant fuck laser. Yeah, you tell that asshole. What do I get if I help both of you guys? Cutter? That's lame. Ooh, an invincibility candy. Yeah, it's probably like, oh, if you want an invincibility candy, go up. If you want a max tomato, go down. Of course, not that you'd ever know that. But you get to kick some ass at the end of the level. Is there not a fight with the Meta Knights in this level? I thought there was totally a fight with the Meta Knights. Maybe not. Here's where the paths meet up. Yeah, there is a fight with the Meto Knightokyos. That is so stupid. This hat is so stupid. Dude, stop it! Ugh. Dude, you gotta stop. And my eye has gotta stop itching, too. And the sun has gotta get out of my eyes! I'm gonna die because there's so many little minor annoyances coming at my fucking self in this bot, in this encounter. I'm gonna lose subscribers over this video. Okay, seriously. There you go. Oh, there's one more. Don't kill me! Of course, now I get to fight the boss with one health left. That's gonna go real well. But I got an extra life. Nice round 36. That's a good number. 36. And it's a real shame, too, because I mentioned that my volume dial only goes in twos. Well, I really wish it worked otherwise, because, like, because there are so many odd numbers that are good numbers. But anyway, here's the boss. It's Meta Knight himself. Meto Knightokyo, the man himself. How many hits is it going to take to do the man in? Probably more hits than I got. Yep, there I go. Just jumped right into him like a dumbass. But come on, I just fought Dark Link at the end of Zelda 2 earlier today while I was in the bathroom. This fight with Meto Knightokyo should be no problem. Well, there you go. And indeed, this fight really isn't that hard, because if you're used to other fights with Meta Knight, this fight isn't going to pose even a remote threat. It's cool, but it's a really simple, it's a nice simple sword fight, but it's no problem. You die. Sheesh. There you go. No problem. Yay. So happy. And on to level 7, with the music we've already heard twice before because they awkwardly shoehorned it into the end of World 6. Next time on Kirby Nightmare and Dreamland, we will finish the game! Unless I want to do Meta Nightmare, which will probably be like a different LP, honestly, because Meta Nightmare is harder, and it's, well, yeah, it's harder. See you next time. Bye! Da, da, da.
You're gonna have to give it your all to get through Rainbow Resort.
That was lyrics in a YouTube comment I saw once. Bye!